Remember when you were a kid and you were taught to look both ways before you cross the street? Wouldn't it be nice if whenever you cross a one-way street, you only had to look the direction that cars are supposed to be coming? Not in Vegas. Not in Vegas. Trooper, today is Sunday, it's 1:52 p.m. Wait a minute, 1:52? What the hell? Didn't I say I was gonna get an early start today? That's not an early start. Alexa, what the weather is?
In Las Vegas, it's 51 degrees Fahrenheit with mostly cloudy skies. Today, you can look for intermittent clouds, with a high of 53 degrees and a low of 42 degrees.
Learned a lesson about these things. You gotta brew the coffee and then let it cool before you put the lid on. I just burnt all my shits right here. This shit is gonna be no skin on it left. Damn, boy. Note to self, brew the shit, let the shit sit there for like 3 minutes. Then put the shit on the shit and drink the shit. What? Feeling today? The Earl. First of all, is this chick trying to get killed? Is that her intention? Is that her goal? Of all the dumb shit you can do in Vegas, that's one of the dumbest. So I guess, second of all, I was really feeling Aria yesterday. So I think I'm gonna go back over there and check it out again. So third of all, we got some shell game action going. Whether they actually have any suckers, I'll never know. Fourth of all, okay, let's stop keeping count. Somebody said something new opened at Cosmo, and I can't remember what it was. But it was something they thought I would be interested in. And now I don't even remember if it was something I would be interested in. Let me see if I can figure that out. No. 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 Hell to the fuck no. Nope. Found it. It's called Hattie B's Chicken. Apparently they got this new little like food court type situation over here called Block 16. Let's see what we got. Hand roll and sake. Hattie B's fried chicken. Pig out. Must be barbecue. Pock pock wing? What? Expected on the strip, all that shit is overpriced, but it's like a little like I don't want to say food court because it's not, you know, Nathan's and Panda Express or whatever. So the Pock Pock Wing place is a Thai place. One place was like a barbecue and burgers, but they also had something called a pho something, I don't know. That little district joint looked pretty awesome. They had biscuits. So like biscuits with stuff on them. But they also had something called a croak nut, which was an unsweetened fried donut that they used to make sandwiches out of. The donuts looked good. The Hattie B's fried chicken, I didn't actually see any of the chicken, but I saw the prices. It's $11 or $12 for a two-piece, like, fried chicken meal or whatever. If I hadn't eaten Earl, I would have gotten something from there in some way. So yeah, that's on the second floor of Cosmo, right when you walk off the bridge. It's interesting to find new shit in Vegas, right? Not gonna lie, I was this close to getting one of those donuts. This close. I know it's not gonna be Donut Bar. Donut Bar has to be better, right? I may have to try it though. Maybe we should do Donut Week. What? Hit all the donut joints. That sounds slightly unhealthy. Yo, Shops at Crystals. I love Christmas as much as anybody. But it's January 6th. That shit's gotta come down. Yo, of all the poker rooms in Vegas that allow you to call ahead and get on the list, which I think maybe all of them in Vegas do, but out of all of them, Aria is the most important. If you don't get on the list at Aria, you could potentially be waiting a long time. I called yesterday, I still had to wait. But I called a good 15 minutes ago right now. So maybe we won't have too much downtime sitting around waiting to get into a game today. had to get up and stretch my legs a little bit here, grab a coffee. Not very much going on in the game for me. Pretty damn card dead, to be honest. Let me see if I can think of a story or something to tell you from the table. There aren't any. Not yet. Done. Just had to be done. All right. It's 9:43. I lose 202. The game was really good, I just couldn't get anything going. I was down 200 in the first, probably about an hour into the game, I was down 200. This old dude, he's about to turn 80 years old. Dude asked for two setups in the first 3 hours, just tried to ask for another one. And I told the dealer, I was like, dealer, this will be the third setup change in 3 hours. Fortunately, we didn't have to sit through another one. I got news for the old guy. They bring two new decks of cards. They're gonna have the exact same cards as those two decks of cards. 52 cards, four suits, 13 cards in each suit, ace through king. Not really sure. Not really sure the logic behind asking for a setup. Oh, well, I know why, because there is no logic behind asking for a new setup, unless someone is cheating or marking cards or something, but that wasn't the case. This old dude probably asked for five setups a day, every day of his life. Come to think of it, I did play one decent pot about 3.5 hours ago, maybe 4 hours ago, probably 3.5 hours ago. I had 8-9 of hearts. I limped in. Dude two to my left made it 15. And the old dude in question called, so I called. I believe it was king high with two hearts. I check, the original raiser bets 15 again. Old guy calls 15. And this is one of those situations where at this point, I'm pretty much just playing against the old dude. Guy two to my left doesn't have much. The turn card came, the deuce of hearts. I checked, two to my left bet 20. Old guy called 20, so I just called the 20. River card is like some kind of meaningless card. So I paused for a second. And then quickly grabbed 100 out of my stack and pushed it in the pot, like pretty quick. Two to my left, original raiser, actually thought about it. I don't know what he was thinking about for so long, but he finally folded and old guy snap called. Old guy had about 200 total. If I'd known he was gonna snap call, but then again, I don't know if he would've snap called a shove, but he snap called that 100. Maybe he just didn't believe me. Who knows? Well, that was like 3.5 hours ago. I was down 200 going into that hand. About an hour ago, this chick opened a 20 out of turn. And the guy on her right was thinking about what to do before she did it. And then he called three because her 20 that she put in is now binding if he doesn't change the action. So she puts her 20 back in. Two people call, and then the guy whose turn it was when she originally put the 20 in, he 3-bet and ended up breaking somebody in the hand with aces. The entire table saw her put 20 in out of turn.
The dealer pushes it back. The dude then limps in for three. And then two people call the 20 after her. And someone goes broke in the hand. It's 2019. That kind of shit still works. Yo, I'm out of here. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. Yo, I'm gonna see you next time.